Don't be like everyone else. Be yourself. Be your own true self. Be the best you that you can be. Today, I'm here to tell you that you should not be like everyone else. You should try to be a bit more original. This goes back to some advice that I keep hearing, and in fact, that I've given myself. And so I want to talk about it. I want to qualify it. Unfortunately, a lot of people, when they're creating their online profile and when they are, you know, signing up for Upwork or Pros or Translators Cafe, or making their own website or something along those lines. Basically, they have their profile and their CV, their photo, whatever information. They're not sure what to write. They're not sure how to structure it. They're not sure what to say, what not to say, what to leave out, what to put up front, etc. So what do? They go look at what other people have done. And that's very natural. If you're up on Pros, you go look at other profiles. They're like, well, how did other people do it? What did other people say? How did they word it? How did they structure it? What seems to be the norm? And if you have no idea what to do, then yeah, you can look at what other people do and kind of get an idea. Unfortunately, what happens is, say, you'll look at 10 different profiles and you'll notice 9 of them have done this, and you'll say, okay, that must be the standard way to do it. And so you do that. Unfortunately, we do this a lot without thinking, because we assume, I just joined this place. These other people have been working for a while. They must know something I don't. So that's the way it should be done. But very often, more often than you would think, if you are looking at 10 different profiles, and 9 of them did something and 1 of them didn't, that one person is the one who stands out. So you really need to evaluate. If you're looking at a profile and all of them have listed their languages in a certain order, or have done things in a certain way, except for one, maybe this one forgot, maybe this one was lazy, maybe this one just didn't finish their profile or something like that, in which case it's fine. But maybe this one person actually stands out. Maybe they did it on purpose, and maybe that's why they structured it this way, in order to be different. The fact is, when you come from the point of view of someone who's hiring, and I can say this because I've hired many times off Pros, off Upwork, off other places like that, you end up getting a lot of people who send in their resume, who apply for the job. Any given job I get, it'll be at least 20 to 30 people, usually more. So if someone is sifting through 20, 30, 50, even 100 different profiles in order to figure out who to hire for this job, then they start blending in altogether. And after a while, even after I whittle it down to say the top 10 people that I want to hire, I don't remember their names. I don't necessarily remember where they're from or the details they said in their CV, but there will be something that stands out. And many times it's that one different thing. So when you are looking at other profiles, obviously if you're not sure what to do and you don't want to have an empty profile and you don't want to do anything wrong either. On the other hand, you shouldn't always be asking yourself, what did everyone else do? But you should be asking yourself, what stands out? When I'm looking at 10 different profiles, which did I notice first? And why did I notice it? What was it that stood out? What was it that caught my eye? And it'll usually be something, maybe it's something in the picture, maybe it's something in their title, maybe it's something that they say. Maybe they say, hey, I'm a translator by day, but I'm a DJ and hip hop artist by night, or I don't know, something along those lines. If you can have something that helps you stand out, then that very often can make the difference. Obviously, if you have a really crappy work history or something like that, then that's what you need to be working on. But if you do have a decent history, and if you've been working and if you've been accumulating some experience and you want to stand out, then you need to find a way to do it. Because unfortunately, if people are going to be sifting through 50 different profiles, they're not going to remember you. Even if you do a good job, many times that's not enough, because you won't stick in their mind and they might overlook you, or they'll see 5, 7 other people who also did a very good job and they don't know who to pick. And someone who has that spark, who has a little bit of personality, who stands out a bit, that could be the winning thing. So when you do what they call it benchmarking, where you look at other profiles, you look at other people, you look at your competitors and you try to see what they're doing and you see how you measure up compared to them. It's not always good to try to do that, to try to measure up compared to them. Sometimes you want to stand out a bit. And if you find somebody else who does stand out, ask yourself why. Don't do the exact same thing, because then you'll be exactly like them. But hopefully this will give you a spark and give you some ideas as to what to do. I know that I've mentioned in the past in my course, and I'm sure in videos as well, that if you don't know what to do, look at other people's profiles and it gives you an idea of what to do. And this is true when you're first starting out. If you have no idea how to structure your profile, then yeah, check out 10 other profiles. It'll give you an idea and then you can do what you need. But at that point, you need to say, okay, now my profile looks like everyone else's. Now I need to do something that makes it stand out a bit. And at that point, it's going to have to be you with your creativity. Because if I tell you what it is and everyone does the same thing, then it won't be original, will it? But have something that helps you stand out, hopefully in a good way, but even just so in a way that when people go through it, they'll be like, oh yeah, that was the hip hop artist, that was the DJ. And it's something that sticks and it gives you a personality and it gives you a reason to make it to the final round, let's say, of people, because right away they'll remember you rather than just forgetting you because you blend into everyone else's profile. So I just wanted to point this out and point out some of the nuances that can come out when you're trying to benchmark, when you're trying to create your profile. Because yeah, you do want to make sure you've crossed all the T's, you've dotted all the I's, and you've done everything correctly. And for that, you want to look at other profiles, but you also want to be different. And you don't want to be like everyone else. Anyway, I hope you find stuff like this useful. If you did find it useful, please don't forget to click like, because that's the best way for me to find out if you find something useful or not. Please don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video where we'll talk about freelancing. We'll talk about freelance translation and other things associated with it. Okay, thanks. Bye.